Conference with the bride.
Conference with
many the bride. Women are ignorant.
Many men
but she
need
knows
to know
something
about
the approximate topography of the vagina,
organs,
the clitoris,
the nature,
the hymen,
the
cervix, the uterus,
also,
the
tubes,
and the
ovaries.
Also, an explanation
tract,
of how conception takes place.
The size,
information
the
about the length,
the vagina,
width, and the related
the
characteristics
of
the vagina, because it's more girls than one would assume,
the location,
may help to assure
the
occasional baseless worries about genital
and also about the cervix and the woman's inner organs. Also,
major fears of hemorrhage and severe pains.
Tearing,
breaking,
the process of conception,
that deflowering are not unusual even today, and in most cases can be corrected by explaining the anatomy of the hymen. Some pointers on honeymoon
any
behavior
fear of injuring
a
bride
point,
of small stature,
not to consider women lacking in virility of deflowering,
or even
first
intercourse
does not take place exposed night for various reasons.
Also,
a word of
there should be a discussion
of proper attitude,
although some caution is
advised
as a husband may help
become
the first mother
because of
overexcitement,
the
deep
extreme anticipation
should occur later,
with alcoholic
ease and the physician's
anticipate. And in some
work, the bride is
a reminder to schedule the wedding
after,
rather than before
the
menstrual period.
If the latter finding is made on gynecological examination, or from the history,
such as the man has to penetrate the small
cavity
of the meanwhile to transcend
discussion,
and that
the
female cause
of
the injury
and infection, or
has been known to cause some brides to keep resisting complete phallic emission. Or, I believe that ejaculation in lower
a discussion
of deflowering
would include
draw
importance
has led to time
and patience on the man's part
pregnant
overcoming the bride's resistance.
Some physicians prefer to help
or
not
fears
to
not
to cause future sexually difficult
difficulties.
To demonstrate
such advice
as
relative
pain
of excessive
fear,
as well as
causing
pain
or hemorrhage and
direction
from the spirit
extent
which may inhibit
the normal rigor of the phallic thrust.
There should be instruction.
The young bride often needs to be told
that women have no ejaculation
as men have,
or any
significance
that deep
or lack of significance
as well
as during
the presence or the absence of cervical mucus at orgasm should be explained, as some women and their husbands believe that they are under
this guidance may be combined with some
advice
on
cohesion.
For instance,
it should be mentioned
that orgasm
in women
is not
a desirable part
of sexual emission
during the first night,
but it may take a few months before orgasms
are unwrapped
by some
nervousness,
and that a woman's
or
multiple orgasms during
wedding
sex
are
the
circumstances
that
travel
with
them,
and that
it is
inadvisable
to interrupt
her travel
and
to destination during the first night
if she encourages her husband
to initiate
ritual
relations
at some
in the
hotel
or
to indulge in pre-clinical foreplay.
It is also inadvisable to attempt first intercourse, especially
deflowering
in an uncomfortable
dance of the act,
conveyance,
car,
gorilla birth,
etc.
Or to have first intercourse,
in
fact,
any
part of the honeymoon
to
the home of the parents or other relatives of family, or wherever there is a lack of physical
and
psychological privacy,
and the testes,
and that to indulge excessively in alcohol drinks before the first
coitus, that drops of urine will
it may lead to temporary
impaired
potency.
And
harmless
in itself,
but in oversight
of
husband
and
psychological
complications.
Generally, hectic journeying from locality to locality during the honeymoon of things that men do not have administration and affixed or any equivalent thereof. The nature of men's ejaculation, and that the masculine sex
it is useful not to say a few words about the nature of sexuality in women, especially that it is normal for a girl to be desirous and responsive. That women experience orgasms but have no ejaculations. Although cervical secretion may be present
beyond those already mentioned,
that women are not overstatistically if they have several orgasms in quick succession,
if she is not strong enough,
or if they express desire to be stimulated in various ways
the
groom should be instructed in ways of making reasonably simultaneous orgasms
very often
both partners possible,
conscious or unconscious,
either by self-restraint before coming,
perturbing sex,
or by stimulating the bride's responses by generating
the genitalia or reactions in some way, so as to make the past indulgence obvious to the husband.
The need of many women for tenderness after the act
of a child
holding rather than turning away may be
mentioned. Such a girl a good
however,
attempt to find and correct the underlying motive should be made. If this proves to be impossible, if they
advise some proper position
for psychiatric evaluation that should be considered
during intercourse,
the milder cases,
rather than the
discussion of sex,
that the man's weight should be partially supported by his elbows and knees rather than being a dead weight in pubis, especially where there is disproportionate stature. Or that ordinarily in the basic or main position,
man's layer of sex and
hymen may be motivated by
questions
related to the frequency of intercourse,
abstinence during the wife's menses,
required by use
need not
rather than by actual
premarital
experience.
Mental linking
however,
sex with vulgarity.
He may be asked about worries regarding
erotomy over fastidious
past
or present
masturbation,
homoerotic
modesty,
fear of being observed,
or preoccupation concerning his genital
organs
and
intimacy
with another person,
and a fear of manifesting her own sexual impulsiveness and enjoyment.
Where her husband bears
the fear to be
the sexual act consists
rigidly
of the insertion
of the erecting
penis.
Fear of pregnancy,
distaste
for motherhood,
and a series of child-resting motions during which the organ does not leave the coital channel.
In the presence of obvious
usually, the act is terminated after the
ejaculates.
If normally,
the
phallus
advances
throughout the length
or otherwise collected out of existence,
the glands brushing against
the tip of the cervix
may require brief
psychiatric
vaginal
in order to prevent serious.
The woman's normal role is not passive, but she delivers pelvic counter thrusts of varying vigor.
Details of coital technique are regarded most frequently as the responsibility of the
humans, unlike most animals,
probably have no instinctive knowledge
of how to cope.
Women cannot be considered immoral.
They must learn this in hearsay,
sex
instruction,
the demonstration
of other sources,
and my body motion.
For instance, totally naive couples have been known to resort to near
or regard phallic emission
because they were unacquainted
with their
intercourse
and experience.